DTIS is just a pair of cameras like you could buy off the shelf in any photographic shop, but it's special because we can put it down to 6,000 meters in the ocean. And the clever thing about it is that we can dangle it on a wire, just a normal CTD conducting cable from the ship, and we can put it down right to the bottom of the ocean, and we can see in real time color video of the seabed. But better than that, we can actually bring back high definition video and very, very high definition still images, which gives us a picture of the structure of the seabed and the structure of the animals and the environments that they live in. In a general sense, we go exploring. It's the only scientific tool we have in New Zealand with which we can actually go to most of the depths of the ocean around New Zealand and actually see what's there. We use it in context. So first of all, we go out with a multi-beam system. We map the seabed acoustically with that, a broader scale. But that, well, it gives us a picture of the symmetry, the shape of the seabed, the structure of it. We can't actually see what lives there, and we can't actually see what it's made of. It's when we go down with a camera that we start to see the way the organisms interact with the environment, the patchiness of animals, so why you find some animals in one place and not in another. And the ultimate goal of what we're doing is to map the seabed around New Zealand so that we can actually say with some confidence, you're likely to find this kind of animal there. You're likely to find this kind of seabed there. That's the aim. The challenges with the DTIS are much the same with any deep water sampling gear. You're working from a moving platform, an open ocean, anything up to 4, 5, 12 meter swells running. And we're putting down a tool that we hang 2 or 3 meters above the seabed. And it can be 1,000 meters, it can be 2,000 meters, it can be 3,000 meters below the vessel. So if the vessel's going up and down at the surface, then our camera is going up and down at the bottom as well. We're heavily dependent on what the sea state is like. The other problem is the pressure increases dramatically as you go below the surface. We have to build a system that will function at great ocean pressure and stay dry while it's doing it. Just a small amount of ingress will short the electrics and we have to bring it back and find out what's gone wrong. It's all very well taking cool pictures of the seabed, but the essence of this is the science of it. So we have to turn the images into a format that we can actually compare with other places we've been to, do some quantitative analysis of what we're seeing. So when we're watching the video, we're actually recording in real time what we're seeing. So we're recording a description of what the substrate's like, and we're recording all the animals and all the organisms that we're seeing down there. When we get the full resolution imagery back on the surface, then we go through it in detail back in the lab, and essentially we're turning what we see on the seabed into numbers that we can put into a computer, quantifying the seabed and trying to make some sense of it.